This Week in Nerf, we're not in front of the blaster wall. I'm sitting down because I injured my back. So we're doing this a little bit more casual because, like I said last week, it's the holidays. But we got stuff to talk about, so let's go ahead and get to it. Let's start off with Worker Talon mags. These were announced and are becoming available through various vendors. It is Worker's answer to the Jet Katana mags. Now, this is a half-dart mag system, and the first thing to talk about is that these are not Katana compatible. So you cannot mix and match between systems, which, to me, is a bummer. It's a big, big bummer, and it's going to prevent some people that have bought into the Katana system from potentially buying into this system, which, who knows if these will be more readily available more often than Katana mags or what's going to happen, but it's definitely a bummer to me about that. But I do like that we have another offering to go with the multitude of community-made offerings we have as well. So more and more options are becoming available for small form factor short dart magazines that we have not had in the past. So that is definitely, definitely a plus. Also, something to note for this is you notice there's no mag release on there. It's a friction fit that uses a detent that you can just yank it out, I guess, is how it works. I haven't gotten my hands on them yet, but once I do, I'll be able to confirm it. So that's definitely an interesting design choice and design change. So I'm kind of curious about how that's going to perform in actual gameplay. I hope it's strong enough that jarring of the blaster is not going to cause the mag to fall out, but also not so tight that you have to really yank and kind of change your blaster orientation to pull it out, because I want to keep my blaster as close to on target as I can when I'm reloading, and that may be an issue. So we'll see when we get them in hand, but they are becoming available from overseas and should be available ideally, I would assume. Hopefully soon from the US and other European resellers. So keep your eye out for those for sure. I'm looking forward to seeing how they perform. Absolutely something to look out for. But let's talk about a first party thing. And this is the Ruckus. We talked about this last week, I believe, but it is now available for pre-order on Amazon. It'll be coming out on January 1st. So yay for that. It's $20, which is not bad for the size of the blaster and all of that. It is, like I said, a funky blaster, an interesting blaster, something that is a bit different. So if you're into that, that's an option. Also, we've seen some images leak out, which I don't have quick access to, my apologies, of some of the Marvel micro shots and I believe the Star Wars micro shots and all of that stuff, which is cool. I'm looking forward to them. I want to see them in stores. I know I'll be picking some up. I think the MicroShot line is awesome, and I'm looking forward to the new additions to it. So those, something you can keep an eye out for as well, but I don't want to talk too much about that. Let's move on really quick to Orange ModWorks, Project Orange. There is a new project for a Retaliator or Mark II Recon Slamfire kit, which is kind of cool. It's something that's, I think a lot of people would like if the Retaliator or the Recon Mark II had that ability to do slam fire. So this is something that should the crowdfunding succeed, will be available. And it's something you can get in on now. The Project Orange Kickstarter style thing is up. It is how much? $36 currently. And I believe you can actually get that price lower if you use the Black Friday deal that they have on Orange ModWorks right now over the weekend, if you're watching this right off the bat. Don't hold me to that. I just crossed my mind. It may be a thing. Take a look at it. But that's something definitely interesting and kind of neat. So if you're into that, I like the more stylized triggers here. I think that's kind of, I actually realized I'm using my mouse to point. I have a finger. I can point my hand. I'm tired. But I like stylized triggers. I like changes and things like that to the aesthetic and how things look. So that's just a nice little touch to me. And I really do wish we would see more triggers from creators. things that have more unique looks and more stylized looks. I really, really do think that that's something I would like to see more of. I don't know how well they would sell, but maybe it's just me. Maybe a lot of people will be interested in it. I don't know. That's just a thought I have. And since we're a little bit laid back today, you get to hear my thoughts. So, but that's that. That is something you can take a look at now. And one more thing to talk about today is something that I super thought was cool. Look at that. Look at that thing. That is crazy. That is Black Betty. That is a HPA blaster that just looks gorgeous. Oh my goodness. That thing is amazing looking, and it is open source, and all the files are available. Now, they have made very, very clear notes that this is not a starter build. This is a very heavily involved build, and it's going to require a lot of tuning and tweaking and all kinds of stuff to get working. But I just the amount of detail gone into this write-up and this system, this platform, it looks so clean. I really, really like it. So serious, serious props to the creator. It just keeps going. This write-up is amazing. The people that take the time to invest and document and do write-ups and things like this, thank you. You're awesome people. This is just one more thing to add to our community. There's the end. It finally ended. But I mean, look at this thing. It's just so clean looking. It's so, so nice. And while this isn't something I would run in a public game at a public park or anything because of the colors, though you could change the colors and think about it if you're going to print your own. It's just so nice. And it's so refined. I wanted to share that with you because I want to see these. I want to see more of them. That's just so cool to me. What is the creator's name? Because I can't remember. DaxLR. One of the two. Either way, fantastic work. Absolutely love it. I hope people go and start creating their own, and we see these getting posted for people that want to do HP and want to invest into it, because the blaster is definitely an investment, as they noted, for everything going into it. So definitely, hope to see them, but I don't know that we'll see a ton of them because of that investment currently. But it is cool to see. I love seeing people push the boundaries of things and push evolution of our blasters and what we do in our hobby. So go read that write-up. Go read that link. Check it all out. It's definitely some cool stuff. But this is actually the end of the episode, because this was an impromptu episode. I didn't think I was actually going to be able to film today. And here I am. So we're doing it quick. We're doing it dirty. And we're done. So with that said, if you enjoyed this video and you're new to the channel, this is not normally how we operate. Normally, we are in front of a wall with nice lighting and all kinds of good stuff to share with all the news with all of you. So definitely check back next week. Look forward to that. But if you want to join, hit that subscribe button. Love to have you part of the community. As always, thank you so much for watching. I'm Jangular, and I'll see you next time.